subscribe button to subscribe to our channel. Press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
What are the different types of events, right? And few notes, right? So here, now I'll tell you about the total probability and the Bayes theorem. Then once we finish this, we can start the problems based on that, okay? Total probability. Let E1, E2, E3, so on up to En be the mutually exclusive and exhaustive events of the sample space S and A be any event of S, then total probability P of A is equal to summation P of Ei into P of A by Ei. Okay, I is equal to 1 to N. Right, events to be mutually exclusive, then and here A is some event which is common to all events, even E2, E3, so on up to En, then we can write P of A, the total probability P of A is equal to summation I is equal to 1 to N P of A Ei into P of A by Ei. Right, the next Bayes theorem. Let E1, E2, E3, so on up to En be the mutually exclusive and exhaustive events of the sample space S and A is any event such that A is contained in or equal to union of all Eis, E1 union E2 union so on En, then see that here A is such an event, okay, or A is an event such that A is contained in or equal to union of all Eis. It doesn't mean that it is contained in that, it means that A is common term or common to all these events. If you are talking about defectives, right, if you are talking about defectives produced by all the machines, okay, then that becomes the common term of all these. So A should be common to all these, it means that then P of Ei by A, okay, then the conditional probability, I'll write here, then conditional probability P of Ei by A is equal to P of Ei into P of A by Ei by the total probability, that is summation P of Ei into P of A by Ei. Okay, this is called Bayes theorem, from which we'll find out the conditional probabilities like this. Okay, and now we'll write few note okay, if A and B are independent events, then A complement and B, A complement and B, A and B complement, then third, A complement and B complement are also independent. Okay, if A and B are independent, then A complement and B, A and B complement, A complement and B complement are also independent. Okay, note 2, P of A intersection B is greater than or equal to 0. Is greater than or equal to 0, and P of A union B is less than or equal to 1. Then if A is the subset of B, then P of A is less than or equal to P of B. And we know that summation of the individual probability is equal to 1, right? If suppose E1, E2, so on up to EN are the mutually exclusive and mutually exhaustive events, then I can write P of E1 plus and so on P of EN is equal to 1. Okay, if they are exhaustive events of S, then I can write P of sum of the individual probabilities equal to 1. And one more thing what we have is, and one more note, complementary events, are not independent because the occurrence of an event E prevents the occurrence of E cap. Okay, complementary events are not independent. It means that P of E into P of E intersection, sorry, P of E intersection E complement is not equal to P of E into P of E complement. Okay, complementary events are not independent because of the occurrence of an event E prevents the occurrence of E complement. If E happens, E complement doesn't happen, right? So therefore, they cannot be independent. Okay, this was regarding the note and the few definitions what were left. Okay, so we completed that. Now we are going to start few problems based on all these topics, then we'll move on to multiple choice questions based on that, right? Okay, so problem 1, what is the chance that a leap year selected at random will contain 53 Sundays? What is the chance for a leap year to contain 53 Sundays? right? We know that leap year has 360 days, which is equal to 52 weeks plus 2 days. It means 52 Sundays plus 2 days can be any. Okay, it can be of this form: Sunday, Monday, Monday, Tuesday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Thursday, Friday, Friday, Saturday, Saturday, Sunday. Right. So in this we are getting two combinations where we are getting one Sunday. Okay, here we can have one Sunday, or here we can have one Sunday. Right. So there are two chances out of seven having one more Sunday. Okay. So there are two chances out of seven. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. There are two chances of having one Sunday in this particular combination out of seven. So therefore, required probability is equal to 2/7. We have 52 Sundays. We need one more Sunday that can be in this seven combinations. So two combinations are favorable out of seven. So therefore, the required chance is 2/7. Am I clear? The next. Second question. Three cards are drawn from a pack of 52 cards. Find the probability that three are spades and second two spades, one diamond, third option one spade, one diamond, one heart. What is the question asked? In a pack of 52 cards, if three cards are drawn at random, find the probability that there are three spades, or three spades are drawn, two spades and one diamond. Because out of three, three should be spades. In the second, two spades and one diamond. One spade, one diamond and one heart. You know that in a pack of 52 cards, okay, we'll have 13 spades, 13 clubs, 13 clubs, 13 hearts and 13 diamonds. Right. Then for the first one, three spades. Okay, out of 13 spades, three has to be drawn. Drawing three spades out of 13 can be done in 13C3 ways. That is the favorable number of cases. Drawing three cards out of 52, that can be done in 52C3 ways. Right? So required probability is equal to 13C3/52C3. Because we are drawing three spades out of 13, that can be done in 13C3 ways. And the total number of cases are 52 cards. Right? So drawing three cards out of 52 can be done in 52C3 ways. So 13C3/52C3. Okay, which can be solved. Second, drawing two spades and one diamond. Okay, required probability is equal to 2 spades. Drawing 2 spades out of 13 can be done in 13c2 ways and z. So you have to use multiplication. If used or you need to use plus, right? 13, what is that? 2 spades and 1 diamond. So 2 spades out of 13 can be done in 13c2 ways into 1 diamond out of 13 can be done in 13 ways or 13c1 ways by how many cards we have drawn out of the 52? 3. So total number of cases are 52c3. Then third, what is that? 1 diamond, 1 spade and 1 heart. So from 13 13 13, drawing 1 1 1, that can be done in 13c1 ways, 13c1 ways, 13c1 ways, right? So required probability is equal to 13c1 into 13c1 into 13c1 by 52c3. Okay, so these are the required probabilities. Now we'll see the third question here. Three light bulbs are chosen at random from 12 bulbs, of which 5 are defective. 5 are defective. Find the probability that all are defective. Second, 1 defective. Third, 2 are defective. Okay, so what is it here? Out of 12 bulbs, 5 are defective. Okay, 12 bulbs, 5 are defective. Then how many are good? 7. Remaining 7 are good, right? So how many bulbs are chosen? 3. 3 out of 12 bulbs. So total number of cases are 12c3, because drawing 3 out of 12, that can be done in 12c3 ways. Okay, so 12c3, so 12 into 11 into 10 by 3 factorial, right? So 3 factorial, so this is 2, so this becomes 220. Okay, so these are the total number of cases. Now in the first bit, what is said here? All should be defective. How many defectives are there? 5 defectives. And how many I am choosing? 3. So all the 3 should be taken from the defectives only. Okay, so required probability is equal to 5c3, okay, by 12c3. All should be defective, so therefore I should select all the 3 from the 5 defectives. That can be done in 5c3 ways by 12c3 ways. So that is equal to, okay, 5 into 4, okay, 3 factorial, 3 factorial get cancelled, and here 5 into 4 into 3 factorial by 2, okay, by here 220. So 2 ones, 2 twos, so 10 by 220. 10 by 220, so that becomes 1 by 22, or we'll see doing that calculation later on. Okay, so that will take much time. Then second, required probability is equal to what is said, one defective, means you have to take only one from the defectives and the remaining two, because we are selecting three, right? Remaining two from the good items. So 5c1 into 7c2 by 12c3. Only one defective should be there, so selecting one out of five, so 5c1 base, and the remaining two should be from good, so 7c2 by 12c3. Then third, what is that? Two defectives should be there, right? So required probability is equal to two defectives should be there, right? So out of five, I have to select two, so that can be done in 5c2 ways. And one more should be taken from good, so that can be done out of seven in 7c1 ways by 12c3, right? Then fourth question. Four persons are chosen at random from a group containing three men, two women and four children. Show that the chance that exactly two of them will be chosen is, two of them will be okay, exactly two of them will be children is 10 by 21. Okay, four persons are chosen at random from a group containing three men, two women and four children, right? So two men, three men, two women and four children, so total number are nine, right? Nine. So total number of cases, n is equal to 9 factorial. Sorry, here, yes, total number are 9, but how many we are selecting? 4 out of this group, 4, right? So I can write here, selecting 4 out of 9 is equal to, n is equal to 9c4 ways. Okay, 9c4, which is equal to 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 by, okay, 9 minus 4 is 5 factorial, so that's the reason I'm leaving that 5 factorial. Okay, then 4 factorial, so 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, right? So this and this will get cancelled, this will get cancelled, and 3 ones 3 twos. Okay, how much we are getting? 7 2's 14 into 9 63 into 2, that is 126. Okay, now what is said here? Exactly in that 4, exactly 2 should be children. Okay, how many children are there? 4c2, required probability is equal to 4c2 into, and the remaining should be, what is said here, 4 persons chosen at random from a group containing 3 men, 2 women and 4 children, show that the chance that exactly 2 of them will be children, 2 of them will be children. Okay, so here 4C2 into, and the remaining should be from men or women, right? Men or women. So 4C2 into, right? So here suppose if I take only one from men, one from men, so 3C1 into, and the remaining one should be from women, right? So two women are there, so 2C1 plus, suppose I take two from men, so 3C2, then I should not take any one women, so 2C0 plus, suppose if I select two women, so 2C1 or 2C2 into, no men should be selected, so 3C0, like this, by, okay, 126. So this is equal to 4C2 into 3C1 is 3 into 2, so 6 plus 3C2 is 3, 2C0 is 1 plus 2C2 is 1, like this, by 126. 4C2 is 6 into 10 by 126. 6 ones, 621s. Okay, so what we are getting is 10 by 21, which is the required probability we have to show. Okay, this was fourth question. Now we'll see fifth question. Seven cards are drawn. From a pack of 52 cards, what is the probability that four will be red and three will be black? Four will be red and three will be black. Okay, seven cards are drawn out of 52 cards, so that can be done in 52C7 ways. Right, drawing 7 out of 52 can be done in 52C7 ways. So n is equal to 52C7. Okay, then what is said here exactly? 4 should be red and 3 should be black. We know that in a pack of 52 cards, 26 red will be there and 26 black will be there, right? So required probability is equal to, we have to draw 4 red out of 26, so 26 C4, and what is said, 3 black out of 26, so 26 C3, by 52 C7. This is the required probability. Now we'll take sixth question. The sum of 2 non-negative quantities is equal to 2n. Find the chance that their product is not less than 3/4 times of their greatest product. Okay, so what is that here? The sum of two non-negative quantities means, suppose that x and y are the two non-negative quantities, means x is greater than or equal to 0 and y is greater than or equal to 0, equal to 2n. Okay, let x greater than or equal to 0 and y greater than or equal to 0 be two non-negative quantities. Two non-negative quantities such that x plus y is equal to 2n. X plus y is equal to 2n means y is equal to 2n minus x, or x is equal to 2n minus y. Then what is it that find the chance that their product is product xy is not less than, means it should be greater than or equal to 3/4 times of their greatest product. Their greatest product, they can have the greatest product only when x takes n and y takes n, means n into n, n square. You can have the greatest product only when both takes same values, the largest values, n, n. Okay, then xy is greater than or equal to 3/4 n square. It implies x into 2n minus x is greater than or equal to 3/4 n square. Then rearranging this, we'll get that as 2nx minus x square minus 3/4 n square is greater than or equal to 0. Okay, rearranging this, we can write x square minus 2nx plus 3/4 n square is greater than or equal to, is less than or equal to 0, because changing the sign, right? Then it implies 4x square minus 8nx plus 3n square is less than or equal to 0. So 4 3 is 12. I can write 12 as minus 6 minus 2, right? So you can write 4x square minus 2nx minus 6nx plus 3n square less than or equal to 0. Then 4x if taken, 2x if taken out, then I'll get here 2x minus n minus. From this, if I take out 3n common, what I'll get here? 3n common, then 2x minus n is less than or equal to 0, right? Then 2x minus 3n into 2x minus n less than or equal to 0. Then this gives x lying between n by 2, 3n by 2, because we have the inequality, right? So therefore, here the range is equal to 3n by 2 minus n by 2, which is equal to n. So there are favorable number of cases as n. Then the total number of cases are, total number of cases is equal to 2n. So therefore, required probability is equal to n by 2n, which is equal to half. So the chance for this is half. Now we'll see the next question, seventh one. The probability of horse A winning the race is 1/5 and that of horse B winning the same race is 1/4. What is the probability that either of them will win? And second, none of them will win. Okay, so you can write here P of A is equal to 1/5, P of B is equal to 1/4. Then what is said here? Either of them will win, means either A or B will win. It means we have to calculate required probability is equal to P of A union B, which is equal to P of A plus P of B. These two are mutually exclusive events. If A wins, B doesn't win. If B wins, A doesn't win. Not because it's the same race. The two horses cannot win. Right? If one wins, then the other cannot win that. So therefore, P of A intersection B is 0. I said three axioms. If A and B are mutually exclusive, then P of A union B is equal to P of A plus P of B. Right? So that's the reason I wrote P of A plus P of B, because A and B are mutually exclusive. If one happens, that prevents the other. Okay? So this is equal to 1/5 plus 1/4, which is equal to 4 plus 5, here 4 and here 5, so that becomes 9 by 20. Either of them will win is this. Then next one, none of them will win. Okay, second, none of them will win. Its chances is equal to P of A complement intersection B complement, means one horse A should not win and horse B should not win. So that is equal to, by De Moivre's theorem or De Morgan's laws, we can write this as P of A union B whole complement, which is nothing but 1 minus P of A union B. Or in short, you can remember, at least 1 is equal to 1 minus none. Right? So P of none is equal to 1 minus at least 1. Like that. Okay? So 1 minus at least 1. So which is equal to 1 minus 9 by 20, which is equal to 11 by 20. So 11 by 20 is the chance for that. Right. Now we'll move on to the next question. Eighth question. An integer is chosen at random from the first 200 positive integers. What is the probability that the integer chosen is divisible by 6 or 8. Okay. How many integers are there? 200. So the total number of cases will be 200. So n is equal to 200. Then what is asking? What is the probability that the integer chosen is divisible by 6 or 8? Okay. So I'll write here P of 6 means the number divisible by 6. It means that is equal to, okay, here 200 divided by 6. Okay, so 6, 3s are 18, so 20, 6 3s are 18, right? So 33 numbers are there which are divisible by 6. So 33 by 200. N of 6 by 200, favorable number by total number, so 33 by 200. Similarly, P of 8 is equal to, okay, 8, 200. How many will be there? 8, 2s are 16, 40, 8, 5s are 40, right? So 25 out of 200. Then intersection, so 6 and 8 LCM, 6 comma 8, 2 3s, 2 4s, so 4 3s 12, so 24. Okay, so we have to divide that number with 24, so 200, 24. P of 6 and 8 is equal to 24. Okay, here 200 we have to get. 24 eights. 25 eights is 200. So 24 eight will be less than 200, right? So I'll write here 8 by 200. Now, what is that? Divisible by 6 or 8 means P of 6 or 8 is equal to P of 6 plus P of 8 minus P of 6 intersection 8, that is 8 by 200. So that is equal to 33 minus 8 is 25 plus 25, so 50 by 200. So the chance is P of 6 or 8 is equal to, okay, 1 by 4.